Chancellor, you know, yeah, the one about the dog and the monkey and the possum. Yeah, look at that, it's hilarious. I shared it with you. And check that out. And the show, oh, 3 o'clock, not 3 o'clock. What? You're crazy. Get your watch fixed. Anyway, I gotta go because I gotta finish getting ready.
All right.
Okay, talk to you later. Bye bye.
Wherever
practiced over rehearsal just before y'all got here, a little thing, and I changed the ending in the spontaneous moment. That's what today is all about, though. It's a lot of spontaneous fun. We've worked up some great things for you, but, you know, again, same. Have fun with us. The next thing I'd like to introduce is our wonderful Maggie Willsey, one of the greatest talents in our region. She's a music teacher in our elementary school in Long Falls. She can play, she can sing, she can act, she can dance, and she's got an amazingly talented son, Reed, who we're going to meet later. But Mandy's going to sing one of the best songs from My Fair Lady. I could have danced all night. Mandy.
I could have danced all night. I could have danced all night. And still have begged for more. I could have spread my wings and done a thousand things I've never done before.
Conversation. See? Look, like Maps. How old are you? She doesn't have enough fingers. See,
okay.
It's not even.
All right, look, we need a crew. All right, hold this. Look, where are we going to find a crew? Oh, hello. Maybe we can find a crew out of these fine people.
It's called a captive audience.
It is a captive audience. Don't move. All right. Let's see. Are any among you able-bodied sailors before the masts? Alright, hold on, let's see.
Around the mast.
Maybe if you knew what it takes to be a pirate. There's an idea. Let's see. By the way, my name is Captain Jack Sparrow. You may have heard of me. And I've become aware, quite recently in fact, that I'm in need of a crew. So, let's see who we can find. I need a volunteer, a young volunteer, someone who's, you know, got plenty of years left in there. Oh, you little miss, come up, please.
I'm totally glad not to have a woman on ship.
Does that look like a woman to you?
Okay, so girls are right, but a woman do.
Yeah,
okay,
so I'll kick her off the ship when she turns 15. Alright. What's your name? Riley. Alright. Are you one of those actor people too? Oh. Okay. That's alright. And I need another volunteer. I need a good, strong man. Let's see. Oh, no young men volunteering? I already got a young one, I need an old one.
Oh, a seasoned one.
Let's see, alright, I guess I have to do the picking here. Who's it gonna be?
Seasoned, lightly seasoned.
Who is it gonna be? Coming over here. That one had gold teeth, I like that. You, sir, you there with the BS on your shirt. You're a good, strong young man. Come on up on stage, baby.
Let's give a round of applause, yes.
Can you handle that? Alright. And to show that you're the powder monkey, you get a powder horn.
Don't blow in that.
Now, thanks, you, sir. You ever clean toilets? All the time? Well, you're perfect. Alright. There, I'm gonna need you to hold on to this.
Not for your teeth and not for your hair.
Now, I got news for you.
It's been used.
The toilets on a pirate ship? No pretty. Alright. Now, at sea, sometimes we're going to be at combat because we like to steal treasure.
Borrow.
Ships. Borrow without coming back.
Exactly.
All right. So, for that, you're going to need a sword. Have you ever fought with a sword? No? All right. Well, let's give you a sword anyway. Hey, look at that. It fits in everything. It's perfect size for you. There you go. Now,
almost like we need.
Once you learn how to use that thing, you'll be an expert. But sometimes, accidents do happen. Brad, I'm worried about you, sir. So I think... Oh, that. That.
Oh.
Go ahead and take that, Brad. It goes like, put your hand in there. It's a little hand. There you go. It'll be easier when you don't have a hand.
Do not scratch with that. You scratch various parts of your anatomy with that. It's going to hurt.
I have a great idea. Sometimes you want to stop the enemy before they get close enough to fire with the sword, and when you do that, you need a pistol. Have you ever shot a pistol? Well, there's your pistol now. Now be careful, you'll shoot your eye out, kid.
Yes.
If you do that, Brad, you're going to need one of these. You have a good eye or a bad eye?
They're both bad.
They're both bad, all right. I'll run that one right there.
Also,
you don't look like a pirate already.
It's great. Be a member of the FBI.
All right, now. Three of us have that the two of you don't have that every good pirate needs is hat. I mean, just the hat for you, love.
Oh.
Now you're a real pirate.
All right.
Brad, I got hat for you too.
That's wonderful.
You've been to Long John Silver's. Ship, the seas get rocking, it gets a little wobbly, you don't decide to walk right on the sail.
Let's not talk about that. I get seasick.
That's true. You might fall overboard. Now, we need someone to watch for people that fall overboard, and basically what we need is a lifeguard. On a ship, we're going to call you the bosun's mate. But if something goes wrong, you need your whistle. That way you can blow a whistle to let us know that someone fell overboard. Everyone put that around your neck. You need more hands.
You're helpless.
Now, Bradley, if we fall overboard, it's possible, probable in fact, that a shark might take your leg clean off.
Yes.
Yeah.
Or a lawyer, because lawyers and sharks.
You don't really get to sit down. If you'll do me a favor, stand right here and just put a leg up just like that. Whichever leg you feel comfortable standing on, put the other one up.
We're gonna need a bigger
boat.
Yep.
Intimidate the other men. Can you say "ar," Brad? Ar. That's not bad. That's not bad. Let's hear it, Brad. That was pretty good.
Do you know any other letters of the alphabet? Because we don't.
As long as you know C
and R,
E, you'll be all right.
Yes.
E-love. Can you say "ar"?
Ar.
There we go. I'll tell you what, if you need a good pirate name, I like Red Brad. You are Riley the Fierce.
Alright.
I'll tell you what, for being such a good sport putting up with this, I'm gonna let you keep those prizes. Eh, Cracker Jack? Good job, Brad. Everybody, Brad and Rod.
Can you
grab that?
Oh, right.
See you later.
Pirates.
Did
we get our parents to sign a waiver?
Whatever. This is Graham Avery, a great new addition to our community and a wonderful talent. I was in a place in 1994 in Beaumont, Texas, and we haven't been in a place since then, and we still aren't. But we worked up a little number for you, we hope.
Girls today in society go for classical poetry. So to win their hearts, you must quote with ease Aeschylus and Euripides. One must know Homer, and believe me, Poe, Sophocles, also Sophocles. Unless you know Shelley and Keats and Pope, dainty Debbie's will call you a dope. But the poet of them all, who will start them simply raving, is the poet people call the Bard of Stratford on Avon. Brush up your Shakespeare, start quoting him now. Brush up your Shakespeare, and the women you will wow. Just to claim a few lines from Othello, and they'll think you're a heck of a Shakespeare, and they'll all count out.
start quoting him now. Brush up your Shakespeare, and the women you will bow. If you
just recite an occasional sonnet, and your lamp will have honey in a pocket.
With your pension greedy for pleasure, let her sample your muzzle. But he's such a good sport. He's an amazing banjo player. He can play the violin or the fiddle, depending upon what you need. And a great singer, actor, and his wife, Mary Jane, is here, and she's also wonderfully talented. And I'm so glad when wonderful, talented people retire to this area. It just makes the pool of talent so much more fun to play with. Are y'all having fun? Does anyone really want to join the Pirates? I don't like their benefits. The next song is a beautiful song, Where is Love, from Oliver. And Ben Anderson, come on out here. There you are. Now, a couple years ago, he was our Charlie when we did Really Want That. He was the greatest kid in the world, then he still is. I'm gonna leave you alone. Ben Anderson, Where is Love?
Yes, love. Oh, your face looks somewhat familiar.
familiar. Have I threatened you before?
I was just wondering, am I going to get my child back?
Child? That young fellow who sang the song?
No, my daughter. You recruited her just a minute ago.
Child. Monkey. Oh, Powder Monkey. Oh, our new Powder Monkey. Riley the Fierce. Good kid. Great pirate. Come with us, love, and I'll show you where your mischievous miniature moppet lie. Come on.
So sorry about the pirate interlude. That wasn't intended. Actually, we have a wonderful singer for you right now who's going to sing a great song from Fiddler on the Roof, Miracle of Miracles. This is Jordan Jones. Great young man who works with our high school theater program. He is a great talent, and he's been in a lot of shows like Hello Dolly and other shows that we've done here. Anyway, I'm going to leave it alone. Jordan, sing your song.
Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles, God took a Daniel once again, stood by his side and miracle of miracles, walked him through the lion's den. Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles, I was afraid that God would frown, but like he did so long ago in Jericho, God just made a wall fall down. When Moses softened Pharaoh's heart, that was a miracle. When God made the waters of the Red Sea part, that was a miracle too. But of all God's miracles, large and small, the most miraculous one of all is that out of a worthless lump of clay, God has made a man today. Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles, God took a tailor by the hand, turned him around, and miracle of miracles, led him through the promised land. When David slew Goliath, yes, that was a miracle. When God gave us manna in the wilderness, that was a miracle too. But of all God's miracles, large and small, the most miraculous one of all is the one I thought could never be. God has
like a baby if her man goes away. Oh, Thank you. some words that might be a little more appropriate for
hit it, Dan.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80. At the end.
This is good.
We are 60 going on 70. Baby, we gotta live. Matters to us, for the future is fast. We still know how to be. We are 60 going on 70. Come on and fall in line. Having our fun while tears are the young means having a glass of wine. Totally well prepared we are to face this world of kids. We are not giving up our cars until we hit the skids. Kids need us to stay older and wiser, telling them what to do. We are 16 going on 70.
We have another song for you that's actually pretty funny. So you won't know the words. You'll know the song.
May lots and nose drops and mantles start beating. Walkers and handrails and new dental fittings. Bundles of magazines tied up in string. These are a few of my favorite things. Cadillacs and caravans. Pacemakers, golf carts, and porches with swings. These are a few of my favorite things. When the pipes sing, when the balls ring, when the knees go bad, I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so. And crumpets and corn packs or bunions. No spicy hot food or food cooked with onions. Bathrooms and heat pads and hot meals they bring. These are a few of my favorite things.
This is good.
Backpack, confused friends and no need for sinning. Thin bones and fractures and hair that is thin. And we won't mention our short-choking friends. We remember our favorite things. When the joints ache,
when the hips break, when the eyes go dim.
I remember the great life I've had, and then I don't feel so
consider kind of a power anthem for the women. Climb every mountain. And if y'all don't mind singing that for me, I'm going to come up here and watch you.
Yeah.
remember the big large lad came out here at the beginning?
Yes.
Walked the plank. Okay, so.
Oh.
Yes. But before he walked the plank, snagged this right off his little Easter. This is actually, it says, because I had someone back there teaching me how to read. The Hill Country Community Theatre's 2015-2016 lineup. I've got it right here. Off the presses.
Really?
Well, actually, off of his body.
What are they doing?
Okay, well, actually, he said, he had a couple notes here. During this, have Seth Smith. Smith?
Yeah, that's me.
That's you, okay. Get voles. Voles? You're gonna get little rats and things?
Volunteers!
Volunteers!
Yes.
So, get to hand
everybody
out.
Everybody in the show that can, if you have a free moment, we need some volunteers to help this party.
We need some voles! Yes. Pajama girl, she's back again. So, if you can hand set the it says they're right there. Actually, it says it's going to put there. The arrow, right? There you go. You can hand them to them and I go over these wonderful plays that will be playing here this year. That rhyme. Here this year. Which is suitable, but that's coming up next. Anyway. So, the first show of this upcoming season will be called Cooking with Gus. Cooking with Gus is a comedy, very slapstick comedy, it says, about a woman and her boyfriend who everyone thinks are married, but they are not. And she has a cooking show, much like Gordon Ramsay, like Hell's Kitchen, but different. She can't open her mouth in front of the camera, so he hypnotizes her, and that's when things go very, very wrong. Very, very quick. So that's Cooking with Gus. That will be in September 10th through 20th. Then there's Dashing Through the Snow from Jones Hope Hooten, our favorite authors. So what it is it's a parade of eccentric guests arrive at the hotel. It's kind of like Plaza Suite in the Hill Country.
Maybe that doesn't get happen, I'm just going to throw you all kids, okay?
Yeah.
Then, after Dashing Through the Snow, is Dial M for Murder. This. As we all know, Dial M for Murder was made by Alfred Hitchcock into a fantastic movie. So ex-tennis pro is trying to kill his wife because she's not very faithful that way. And he blackmails an old friend, and then things go terribly wrong. Then the second to last one will be a comedy called A Little Off the Top. A Little Off the Top is about two men who are bald. Some of you can relate, but two men who are bald. And they think that if they're not bald, they can get more women. So they search for the perfect toupee and they find it, but they have to share it. And they accidentally set up dates for the exact same night. And again, things go very, very wrong very, very quick. And our musical this year, because we've heard you, we've listened to you, or they've listened to you, is Annie, Get Your Gun. People have been asking for Annie, Get Your Gun for quite a while. Now we are going to do it. That will be... it's about Annie, it'll be a sharpshooter in the Buffalo Bill Wild West show, and that will be our season finale, our wrap-up, our summer musical. So this award should be handed out to all of you. We welcome you to come and see our wonderful shows here, and I believe it's intermission time, and there's cake and stuff and other things. Is there rum?
There's
no rum.
There's a spot of wine and some hot coffee, and happy birthday cake for our community here.
Yes.
Thank you all for coming. You sat through this much.
And my sundial's not working. We will see you in a little bit.